Hello everyone, it's Sabrina Rojek with SabrinaSpeaksSex.com. So, I'm answering another question. I went through my emails and I see this one often and it doesn't sound any kind of way. It's not a judgment, but the question is, hi Sabrina, does size really matter? And it's from a guy. However, I get asked this by girls as well. So let me jump right in. Literally, let's dive in. It's a different answer for everyone. So as far as women's bodies are concerned, women's vaginas, their vaginal canals are, we're gonna have a little A&P lesson here. You asked it, so I'm answering it. Can be different lengths, okay? As well as depending on how much they're relaxed and all of these things and how used to they are to a certain size, because women's bodies do start adjusting a little bit because they can really do some interesting growth and widening, and especially the more she's turned on, then the more opening and spacious that it actually becomes in there usually, even though there's blood engorgement and things like that. So with that said, it could matter to some, and that's truly an individual situation. But what I will tell you, there's a few different statistics on what sizes are the average and on, you know, certain demographics of women that they've polled to say this size is what's fantastic. But let me tell you this, just for a tip or trick, that quite honestly, 5 inches, and give or take an inch, would be plenty. And I'm saying that is that a woman's G-spot is about 1.5 to 2 inches by her vaginal, on her belly side of her vaginal wall. Okay, so for those of you that don't know about G-spot, I'll have to answer that question on a separate one, but that's one of the places, just one of the ways in which a woman can orgasm. And by having those 4 or 5 inches of maleness, or object, then that would be a guarantee that every time you pull out and stroke in, that would hit that G-spot, which could then in turn create an orgasm. There are multiple ways in which women can orgasm, and a lot of women didn't know that either, that there's a clitoral orgasm, there's a vaginal orgasm, there's a G-spot orgasm, there's one that's actually even deeper than that type of an orgasm, and then there's combinations of all of those things. So there's not just one type of orgasm, and different sizes are good or useful, rather, for those different types of orgasm. So I encourage you to learn your partner and what they're comfortable with. If you're a little bit on the, I don't know how else to say it, if you're a little bit on the smaller side, then, you know, absolutely break out. No different positions that are going to work for you. That's the other thing, is if you're on the smaller side, then a doggy might work, or her legs bent up too, you know, would work a little bit better. It's not going to create for as long as longer strokes, if I would say. If you're on the bigger side, those types of positions could be painful for a woman, that not everybody wants you to rearrange her uterus and her cervix coming out her mouth by you banging out all the walls and all that stuff. And sometimes that's fantastic too. So it really just depends on you talking, and you can often tell, you know, if it's too big and it's too much and too fast or too painful, or if there's more stimulation that could be happening in which you would use mechanics, or you could use your hands, or, you know, get her involved in different things like that. So size, it can matter, absolutely. So I'm not going to say that it doesn't, but it's very different for every person that you're with. So you're just going to have to get in there, try it out, see what happens. So thank you so much for sending in that question. I appreciate it. Please keep your questions coming and I'll get through them and start answering them as I can. And you can submit those at info. You know what? Let's do questions at SabrinaSpeaksSex.com and we'll put them on the show or on Blog Talk Radio, or maybe even have you as a guest and I can interview with you. So please continue those questions. Questions at SabrinaSpeaksSex.com. Keep them coming. Let's make it juicy.